Oh, this is gonna be awesome. Oh, what's that? Hello there, Alyshia here from Toy Teardown, and today we're gonna be powering up this Furby's tiny little brain by giving it all the knowledge of the internet.
Furby.
These guys are meant to have a mind of their own, and the original one was banned from the Pentagon for fears that it would be listening and divulge state secrets. Now, there are heaps of different types of Furbies. The one thing they all have in common is that they start speaking Furbish, and the more you hang out with them, the more you speak to them, they learn words in your language. There we go. Let's see if I can teach it a science word. Hey, Furby. Say hydrogen. Hydrogen. So I thought, instead of a Furby I have to teach, I want a smarter Furby, one that can teach me stuff. So let's pull it apart, see how it works. So let's pull it apart, see how it works, and see if I can replace this Furby's tiny little brain with a much smarter one. But first, let's see what Furby does. So its eyes light up. Its mouth moves when it talks. It's got this little button inside for feeding. Its ears move. It also rocks back and forth. It does a lot. Fun fact, the fact that Furby has front-facing eyes means in biology, it's probably a predator. I think it's time to tear this down. This is impossible. Doesn't shut up. So Furbies classically don't have an off switch. I think my sister had one and we had to jam it in a linen cupboard to tell it to stop talking. I don't know if you've ever heard a Furby with its batteries dying before, but it is super creepy. I think we're gonna take off the fur. Oh, this is gonna be awesome. Ready? Ah, okay. Ah, alright, another screw. There's always more screws. What's this bit? Yeah, it's like sewn in. So it's clipped into the body and it's sewn into the ears here. So somebody did not want to get inside Furby. Oh my goodness. More clips. How many clips do you have? Yes. One more. Alright, I think we're there. Yes! Oh, what? There's another clip. Oh, wow, okay, all right. Sometimes I wander back to a time where I wasn't trying to skin a Furby. All right, pull. Yay! Thank you, Zaya. And we have our skinned Furby. That is awesome. Let's take a look at this creepy furless monstrosity. So we've got what looks like a DC motor here. So that's the motor. Under here, you can see a bunch of gears under there. Those will be controlling the ears. Then there's like this sort of like a yellow plate there, which I think, hey, those are the eyes. That's kind of cool. This here was the capacitive touch sensor. That's the speaker plug. And this looks like the microphone. It kind of looks like all of these different control processors are gonna be telling the Furby sort of what to do at what time and maybe how fast. So I'm not sure how I'm gonna hack this. Furby, you've got so many brains. Why have you got so many brains? I'm just gonna keep pulling it apart, see what happens. Oops, maybe I'll just start taking these off. Pull it apart from its face. Got stuck in there. Ooh. Hey, oh cool. Oh. Oh no. This is fine. Did you guys see any fall on the floor? Oh, okay. So actually turns out that all of the ears and it looks like the eyelids and everything are all being controlled by that one motor, which is really, really cool design. But it also means that I did not have to pull this apart as much as I did. So I'm just gonna have to work out how to put these gears back in. I don't know what these are for. They're super weird. Oh man, how am I gonna get that? Oh, what's that? Another gear fell out and I've got no idea where it's from. Is that? Oh. Oh. It's all good. It's just like the gears have gone everywhere. And there's like nothing online on how to fix it. It's just gonna take so long. I just don't think we're gonna be able to get it done today. I don't know how we're gonna continue this episode if I can't put it back together. That's the only thing.
Alyshia, we got you something under the bench.
What? What? What did you do? So I completely ruined this Furby, RIP, but my team went out and got another one so we can continue the build and make this little dude smarter. Let's do this. So for this build, we've got a Raspberry Pi, which is kind of like a tiny little computer, and we're gonna connect that directly to Furby's speaker. The Raspberry Pi is gonna be running a Google Assistant, which is kind of like Alexa or Siri. And when we speak to the Google Assistant, it's going to output to Furby's motor, and hopefully it'll make Furby move when it's talking. Thankfully, Furby's just got this one DC motor which controls all of the movement, which is really useful. So then I just have to update the code and hopefully we will have a much smarter Furby. Hopefully. This is the moment of truth. So we've hooked our Furby up to our Google Home. I hope it's working. I think it should be working if I've done it right. I just need to hit enter now and say something to it. Hey Furby, what is hydrogen?
On the website nationalgrid.com.
Yes!
Alternative to methane, also known as natural gas, is the most abundant chemical element, estimated to contribute 75% of the mass of the universe. Here on Earth, vast numbers of hydrogen atoms are contained in water, plants, animals, and, of course, humans.
Furby, you are so smart now. I am so stoked that that worked. That was one of the hardest teardowns I've ever done. But I'm so stoked, we got it working. I just wonder now what other things I might be able to do with Furby. We'll be right back. So obviously this was a really tricky one. A lot of things went wrong pulling apart this Furby, but I'm really proud of myself for sticking it out and really stoked that my pals from Scitech got me another Furby so I could actually finish this off. If you want to actually know how I ended up doing this, I'm going to put the link in the description for all the instructions. It was pretty tricky though, but maybe you've got a Furby at home that you might be able to pull apart yourself. Until next time though, make sure you like, subscribe, and let us know what you thought about the episode. And that's it for today. Say bye.
No problem. Take care.
Bye.
Hey, Furby. How do I fix the gears on a broken Furby?
Remove the shell. Move the gears up and down together. The gears should move. If they do not, find the gear at fault and gently wiggle it and push it until it turns.